Hello everyone, this is Chris at Streams Church bringing you another Keys tutorial. Today we are covering the song Flood the Earth by Jesus Culture. This song is typically in the key of B, which is what we will be playing it in today. However, the keys are transposed to play strictly in the key of C. For the most part, the different zones that we are playing the song in today, we will only be playing root notes. So let's go through the different sections of the song. We start off in the verses section, right down here on the higher end of the keyboard. We use that for the intro, as well as verse 1 and verse 2. Most of those notes are just A to C to G, but then in the middle of the verses it does go to D to C to F. Alright, after that we go to the chorus section. We will obviously use this for just about all of the choruses. The only exception are the final two choruses, in which the song is at very low dynamics. At that point we will only be playing on the pad. So let's go over the chords for the chorus. Very simple. Root notes. We're going to go from F to A to G. And it just repeats those chords throughout the chorus. Now, you will use the mod wheel throughout the song. The first chorus, the mod wheel will be at 0%. The second chorus, it'll be somewhere around 50%. And you'll hear that it starts to get a little more aggressive. Until we get to the chorus after the bridges, in which the mod wheel is at 100%. And then when we do the last sets of choruses on the pad, it really doesn't matter where the mod wheel is. That pad will still play lightly. Okay, so as we progress through the song, after we've played the chorus the second time, we'll enter the instrumental just before the bridge. For that section, we will be playing right here. The mod wheel will have been at 50% on that last bridge. So we jump into the bridge section, and we want to push the mod wheel to 100%. And at that point, we are playing the chords A to F to C to G. That will be the chord progression for instrumental 1. As well as what we call bridge 1, break down the walls, push back the dark, light of the world, move in our hearts, heaven, flood the earth. So bridge 1 is played twice, and then when it switches to bridge 2, you just lower your notes an octave to the bridge 2 section. However, the chord progression does change. Rather than starting on the A minor, we're going to start on this F. Freedom is here, fear has to leave, pain has to go, darkness retreat. So those chords are F to G to A to C, and then F to G to A, and then a short quarter note on the B, and then a short quarter note on the C. I call that bridge 2A, and then bridge 2B, the last measure, the chords are different. So it goes through F to G to A to C, F to G, and then that last measure is this D right here. I'll go ahead and correct that so that bridge 2 is indicative of covering this D note right here. So once we hit that D note, we're going to jump down to that last big chorus. We play through that, and then for instrumental 2, this is the biggest part of the song. We're actually going to drop the mod wheel and go to the bridge 1 section. Same chords that we would do for instrumental 1 and bridge 1, except in dropping this mod wheel, it creates a more aggressive lead. A, F, to C, to G. So you can hear the difference. If the mod wheel is up, mod wheel is down. And that's pretty much it for Flood the Earth. It is a slightly simplified version There are some lead notes that are played on the choruses, but the electric guitar will be covering those. So we just, and we kind of ran out of room on the keyboard with even just these five sections. So we're foregoing the keys playing those lead notes, and the lead notes that we hear in the bridge section is simplified just a little bit. When we get to the end of the song, as I said earlier, we will be playing those chorus chords on the pad, and you see the pad section is a lot bigger. The reason for that is if our lead singer decides to flow a little bit, we can obviously play the F, the A, and the G in the chorus, but should our lead singer decide to go back to either of the bridges, we are going to play the chord progression for bridge 2A. So that's just playing that F to G to A to C. So keep that in mind. At the end of the song, it'll probably stay light. If we do build on dynamics, we can go back to bridge 2. Or even go back to this chorus here. But once we finally drop dynamics completely, we'll just stay in this pad section. So keep that in mind as we flow. So I'm going to go ahead and play through the song now to give you a demonstration of how all of this flows.
1, 2, 3, 4. Intro. 2, 3, 4.
Notice I moved that mod wheel up already. It doesn't really affect the verse. It doesn't affect the verse at all, really.
Chorus.
It's just so that when we go to this chorus, it'll be slightly heavier. Near the end of this chorus, we're gonna move the mod wheel up to 100%, change to the bridge
instrumental. Down. Well.
Now this last chorus, the mod wheel is at 100%, so maximum intensity here.
Instrumental.
Here we go, we drop the mod wheel.
In.
And then, of course, it just repeats those chords. So that concludes the keys tutorial. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know. I will have this patch available to download down in the description below, so check that out. For those of you downloading the patch, I'm going to go behind the scenes now and show you a few of the settings for adjusting this to your setup in MainStage. So here we go. So I have a few different sections. You don't have to use this particular layout. I've had people ask me about using layouts and their settings. I have my main keyboard here. Typically I use that just as a keys map. And I typically have a few other keyboards. This is what I call my complexity hider. That's for all the different channel strips and different instruments that are playing in the background. And then I have a third one, typically for when I have complex arpeggiations. We don't have that in this song, so really if you wanted to import this patch into your own layout, you would just have to make sure you have two different keyboards and that you assign your channel strips accordingly to either this keyboard or this one. You could honestly have just one keyboard, but it would end up looking kind of crazy. So let's go back into the edit mode and take a look behind the scenes. These external instruments here that you see, they have no MIDI output. These I use on the keys map just to map out the zones. So for example, I was talking about bridge 2. Let me scroll over here to bridge 2. And let me learn that different high note. There we go. So now my bridge 2 is mapped to include that high D note. So those, you don't have to worry about anything. All the rest of the channel strips are configured under MIDI input to be transposed down one half step, and that's because this song is in the key of B. So I typically like to program in the key of C. So in this case, C is just a half step above B. So all of my channel strips, you'll see for the most part, are transposed down a half step from whichever octave they would normally be set to. I also typically take out modulation and expression so that things aren't affected. So these will probably be checked on most of these. Yeah, you can see as I go through some of the channel strips, they're checked off to filter out those MIDI messages. So that's what we have going on here. We have obviously several different channel strips for the different sections of the song. I do have a couple of unused channel strips for some of those lead notes that I was talking about for the chorus that I couldn't fit onto the keyboard. And I also had a channel strip just to add an organ click, but I didn't feel like it added much to the song, so I went ahead and took all of that out. But I left it there just in case I decide to toy with it in the future. So last but not least, this song is set up to go for the original key of B. But if you wanted to change let's say, drop it a full step from B to A. You can pull up for each of these channel strips the transposer, and all you have to do on each channel strip is slide this transpose bar down two semitones to get it from B to A. If we're going to play it in C, you just go up one semitone because there is no B sharp, so we go from B to C, and you do that for all of the channel strips. I believe that just about covers anything you would need to know for putting this patch into your own concert template, but I believe that covers everything, so happy playing, and I'll see you next time.